Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with today's edition of Good Morning Bay Street for Thursday, April 5th, 2012. In the pre-market this morning, it's a mixed picture. We've got stock index futures below fair value. We've got commodities above fair value. So we are looking for a mixed open here in Toronto at 9:30 Thursday morning. Earlier in the week, I was mentioning that the days leading up to Easter are historically bullish. And of course, when you've got a bullish bias to the market, that helps dampen the negative pressure of bad news. Yesterday, the market was focused on news related to Spain, and Spain continues to break down. And so while there was negative pressure yesterday with the bullish bias that Easter brings, the negative pressure wasn't as bad as it could have been. So we've saw a lot of negative pressure on the TSX yesterday, and we took out the recent low. And so we've made a new low. Yesterday we tried to run back up to that low, which will now act as resistance. We saw a lot of downward pressure from the energy sector and especially the gold sector. Not that much from the financial services. So financial services didn't see a lot of fall through to the downside yesterday. Looking at our pieces of the puzzle, the TSX, which started yesterday on a sell signal, accelerated to the downside. The VIX for the TSX, which was already on a buy signal, accelerated upward. We don't have the same amount of downward pressure in the U.S., still waiting for a sell signal for the S&P 500, still waiting for a buy signal for the VIX for the S&P 500, and that is also true of the NASDAQ 100. So yes, we traded down to the lower channel lines yesterday. Yes, the VIX is traded through the upper channel lines yesterday, but they did not close there. So still waiting for more weakness in the U.S. before we actually see major sell signals. No major change for bonds yesterday. We did see money move back into the U.S. dollar. So we've got the U.S. dollar on a buy signal, euro on a sell signal, and the Canadian dollar trading in the channel. Next up, let's take a look at commodity prices, starting with crude oil. Crude oil made a new low for this move down yesterday. We saw downward pressure on gasoline enough to actually give us a sell signal. We closed just below the lower channel line. So we're now on a sell signal for gasoline. We're now on a sell signal for heating oil as of Wednesday's close. And of course, that joins natural gas already on a sell signal. Once again, we're seeing copper trade below the lower channel line, still in this messy range, still haven't made a new high since early February. And so things are looking stable here, but certainly there's no trend going on in the price of copper. Gold had a big down day yesterday. It's up a few bucks in the pre-market this morning, and silver was down sharply yesterday. It is now on a sell signal. It's up a little in the pre-market this morning, but certainly nowhere near generating a new buy signal on Thursday. Next up, let's walk through our Horizon BetaPro Bear ETFs that we're following, and starting with the Bear ETF for the TSX 60. So we're now long the bear, of course, and looking for a breakout of this recent high. If we can do that, it's easy to eyeball up here to the December highs. These are the December lows in the market. And if you look at that point, you'll see that we came up and filled this open gap. But then you'll also notice that there's an open gap right here. And so that area could potentially act as resistance on the way back up. So we'll have to see if we can play through that open gap. If we can, then move up to this area would be our next realistic target to the upside. Looking at the energy bear, similar situation. We're well on our way to testing the December highs, which are the December lows in the market. And so that looks like a pretty legitimate target. And if we break through that, then we can go to another chart and find out where the next legitimate target is. For financial services, we closed right on the upper channel line, so no fall through to the downside on Wednesday after the downward pressure that we saw on Tuesday. Again, most of yesterday's weakness was from the commodity sector. So we saw a nice big spike in the gold bear ETF yesterday. We moved up one channel line, and yesterday we were talking about 1250 as our next major target to the upside for the gold bear. For crude oil, you can see that next target would be back here at the February lows. And so that would certainly be a realistic target to see if we continue to move higher. Natural gas, we've blown through most of our upside targets, so we're just sitting waiting to see how long this downtrend in natural gas can go. For silver, we're now back on a buy signal for the silver bear. looking to take out this recent high. And then, of course, our next legitimate target would be way back here at the December lows for the price of silver. And similar situation for gold. We've taken out that recent high, so we're well on our way to moving up here. And, of course, we've got an open gap up here, which could potentially act as a target, a resistance area for the price of gold. Looking at the VIX for the S&P 500, we're still waiting for a close above the upper channel line, above 474. Haven't seen that much downward pressure on the U.S. markets yet. We're not on a sell signal. Still waiting for a close below 2353 for the NASDAQ bull and a close above 436 for the NASDAQ bear. And any lower close for the S&P 500 bull on Thursday would give us a sell signal, and a close above 699 would give us a buy signal for the S&P 500 bear. Last up this morning, let's take a quick look at some 60-minute charts for the TSX. We're certainly oversold. We've got a pressure zone forming. We're down at the bottom of the panic zones. That's the time and place to look for a buy signal. Yesterday, we started to move up. We've got this recent low here that we've broken through that's potentially going to act as resistance. Then we have an open gap here that could also act as resistance on the way back up. We have broken through last week's low. We are looking at two numbers this week, looking to see if we could take out the previous week's high or the previous week's low. And so the low won, unfortunately, for the bulls. So the flypaper channel is currently up at the 12,400 level. For the longest time, we were watching 12,500. Now we've moved down. It looks like 12,400 is our major line in the sand. And you can also look at the moving averages. They're all starting to move lower. They're all on sell signals. Everybody's trading below the 200 hour moving average. And so now we've got a convergence around the 12,400 level. And so if we were able to move up, that would be a major area of resistance. Looks like we're certainly continuing to project lower prices here with the potential of a move up this morning to the bottom of that open gap, and then a move back down. Again, looking at the 60-minute price target chart, you can see that this particular line, the 12,187.50 level, that is an hourly and a daily target. And so we broke through that yesterday, moved down one line, came back up, tried to break out above it. And so if we take out yesterday's low, then our next major daily target is down here at 11,875. Now, on the upside on Thursday, an hourly close above 12,246 would actually generate a buy signal. And that number comes in just below the bottom of that open gap. And of course, the top of that open gap could potentially act as resistance as well. So if we can get a close above, an hourly close above 12,246 on Friday, that would generate an intraday buy signal. Okay, folks, that's all for today's presentation. If I don't talk to you over the weekend, have a great weekend, and I'll talk to you next on Monday morning.